Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We're now going to introduce the SN1 reaction. So a standard model of the SN1 reaction is shown in the upper left. And in this reaction, we know with the S, it's a substitution. With the lower subscripted N, it is a nucleophilic substitution. And the 1 means it is unimolecular in the rate determining steps. And we'll talk what this is. But this is a substitution, and as such, it looks a lot like an SN2 because both of them result in a net substitution. So let's see what the energy diagram looks like. That's on the right. There's something different about this energy diagram. We see that there are actually 2 steps in the reaction. The curve goes up to 1 transition state, comes down to an intermediate, and then goes up to another transition state before going to the product. So that is a difference. So we have an intermediate, and it's actually going to be a carbocation. That's what our intermediate is, and that is going to live right at that point in this energy curve. So let's look at the sample reaction. On this energy coordinate, I've shown it being 2 steps. We're actually going to do a 3rd step on this. So it's actually, well, I'm going to show 3 steps, but classically people consider the SN2 to be a 2-step process. What is that first step? Well, we take our alkyl halide in. And methanol is a typical reagent that we would use for this. Note that there is no nucleophile in here. So this is not going to be an SN2. There's no base, no strong base. It's not going to be an E2. So what can happen? Well, as it turns out, if you have an alkyl halide, that alkyl halide can just leave. This is not a great reaction because it requires us to form a carbocation. But this is our carbocation intermediate. This is not going to stick around long, but that's what our energy curve says. We break a bond and we make a high energy intermediate. This is going to continue to react. So carbocations are strong. They're strongly electron poor. I mean, they have a positive formal charge. They're very electron poor. So this is a strong electrophile. This is wanting to be attacked by something that has electron density. And as it turns out, in this reaction, we have something that has electron density. We have methanol. Now, we could say iodide has electron density. Why doesn't it just attack? Well, it could. Normally, this step is reversible. It goes back and forth. But eventually, you tend to have a lot of methanol around, and eventually methanol is going to find this, and it's going to react instead of the iodide. So it will attack our carbocation. Note that while methanol is not a strong nucleophile, it is a weak nucleophile. And typically in good reactions, we have the reaction partners, one is strong and one is weak. So in this case, we have a strong electrophile and a weak nucleophile. We attack, and that's actually our 2nd step to attack the nucleophile. Now, as it turns out, we need a 3rd step in this reaction because we have to get rid of this extra hydrogen on our methanol, and so we'll use another molecule of methanol as a base to remove that hydrogen. I'm going to draw this final product down here to give me space for the key ideas, but this is our final product. We've done a substitution. We initially had an iodide attached to our T-butyl group. Now we have a methoxy group attached to our T-butyl group. So we've done a net substitution. It took us 3 steps. 2 of them are properly considered the SN1 steps. The leaving group leaves in the first step, we get a carbocation intermediate, and then that gets attacked by another nucleophile. So what are the key ideas? I think a key idea is that we don't have a strong nucleophile or base. That allows this reagent to sit now, our alkyl halide, and decide to form the 2nd key idea, a carbocation. And our carbocation better be stable. Note we've drawn a tertiary carbocation. That's as good as we can get. So that is an outline of the SN1 reaction, completely different from the SN2 and the E2 reactions.